the HoloMedicine program in NUHS started mainly because we believe that this mixed reality platform has a lot of potential when it comes to healthcare applications. How it all started was actually in December 2019 when we were invited by Microsoft to essentially view and have a workshop on the HoloLens 2. So that's when, together with Microsoft and AppleCloud, we did a 6-month proof of concept, and we collected almost 50 different use cases or areas of applications after the 6-month trial. So everyone felt that this is something that can truly be applied to not just training education but patient fronting care. So that's when we decided that, you know, we're going to officially start a program that looks not just at the use or the application of this device but also look at the research and translational aspect for it. We use VSI HoloMedicine in pre-surgical planning. The main focus and the main goal is to look at clinical use cases. How do we apply this on a day-to-day process? How do we use it to treat patients on the ground? How do we use it for patient fronting care? And of course, how do we use it for postgraduate education?
So we can actually use it to teach residents and young doctors how to identify surgical planes, where the tumor is close to which structure, and maybe how to plan operations and what the potential danger areas for during the surgery that we need to be careful about, that kind of thing.
It's like a autopilot, or it's like a flight simulator where you're able to kind of do the whole thing beforehand, before the actual surgery, because some surgeries are extremely complex. And even skilled surgeons would like to kind of use actual images of the patients to plan out the whole surgery. So it really cuts down the time that is required for such planning.
I mean, for now, what we're doing is that we're manually extracting the images from the radiology unit. Very manual process at this point in time. So the ASAP platform, essentially, it's our idea of trying to create an integrated network, an integrated system when it comes to using data. The unique thing about this platform is that it will allow us to pull identifiable patient data in a very secure manner, so we don't have to anonymize it. And essentially, to the clinician that's using it on the ground, it'll be the same as using, for example, a laptop or a computer in a hospital, where they just go in, find a patient, click on it, now they can see the images. They can just do everything on the HoloLens itself.
It's a really super secure defense cloud for hospitals, no? And that doesn't mean you can connect any XR device, you can connect your robots, you can connect medical devices, but you have a super security and you have the advantage of cloud in a combination with on-premise. And I think that is very important, and it doesn't exist yet on the market.
We had to decide or choose between Wi-Fi and 5G. So we looked at a few different things. One, of course, was the transmission speed. So 5G is definitely a lot faster than the current Wi-Fi 5 standard. But one of the biggest reasons why we chose 5G and not Wi-Fi in the end was because of network stability as well as network security. Having the 5G means that I can actually walk around a hospital with my HoloLens without me having to worry about the signal dropping halfway. What we're doing is to try and innovate and, you know, do things that has never been done before. And I think the benefit of us doing this is that, you know, we are able to, in a way, find out where the problems, where the hurdles are, try and cross them, try to find ways to, you know, solve issues as we go along the way. And that experience is quite invaluable. That ASAP model that we have here can be used as a template for other hospitals, other institutes who want to develop something similar. Then we can, you know, customize and we can adjust things with them to suit their needs. Yeah. On the other hand, you know, they are just talking about total, but the
So I think the HoloMedicine program gives us the technological capability of doing something that was very challenging, not just now, but in the future, which is the ability to project objects of light into real world objects that then allow us to undertake a variety of use cases such as navigation, guidance, planning, as well as education. So yeah, certainly I think that HoloMedicine has enabled NUHS as an institution to grow new capabilities that weren't possible previously.
The future of HoloMedicine platform can be in two ways. One, of course, is to have famous hospitals across the world collaborate, build their own scenarios, and have that on the HoloMedicine platform. The second way is, of course, also to have newer use cases. You know, we're looking at identifying veins and arteries. Probably we can go into the pediatric section or the elderly section, have solutions very specific to this group of patients.
And what we see is it's not about just a device, it's about the services, special anchors running on Azure. It's about all the back-end services, mesh, all of this, what will come there, which you need to make a successful XR implementation. It's never just a device, and it's never just a local solution. It must be fully integrated, it must be secure cloud, and that's, I think, the secret here.